Committed. Even you as an individual cannot take steps to arrest the fellow.
It depends on the other person who the fellow is. How
many should be able to do that.
No, I shouldn't be able to
provide for that.
No, sir.
The law provides for that.
No, sir.
The law provides for that.
No, and I say no.
You as an individual.
No, I say no, sir.
So
I say
when
no.
You talk of financial crime,
no, that's
it
not
is
the
not
law.
Limited
that's
to DSSC alone.
No, that's not the law.
The DSS can investigate them. DSS can conduct the raid they have done, and in the manner they have done it, and then bring them to justice. And when you say that they are public officers,
yes,
and because they are public officers,
yes,
judges should not be investigated.
I didn't say they shouldn't.
Or judges cannot, there couldn't be a raid on a judge when you actually know that the DSS has conducted their homework, they have done due diligence, they know that these allegations are likely to be true, and then
Whose agency's job was it in the first place to investigate these judges?
Maybe that's what you should answer. It seems to say that everybody
if
can
it
do
is,
it. And I say
it
number
is,
one.
If it is for matters, for allegations against them committed in the course of their duties as judges, then you report them to NJC. But where these allegations have a coloration of crime, it will be any security.
And I don't know the crime.
It could
quite
be any,
frankly, I don't know the crime. Hold on, sir. Let me.
We have just identified financial.
Okay, fine. Let's elucidate on that. Hold on.
And this is not the first time. Let me say that.
I can't see anything.
Let me say that to you. And this is not the first time a judge has been arrested in Nigeria.
We have not said, sir. We have not said judges should not be arrested.
Your position is that because they are public officers.
Arresting judges.
I don't have a problem with arresting judges. I have a problem with the man and who is doing the arrest.
Excuse me, sir.
That the law doesn't say that you should go arresting judges.
Cite to me.
That
I have
and I'm saying to you, and I'm saying to you, sir. No, and I'm saying to you, and I'm saying to you that under that same administration of criminal justice, hold on a minute. You have law enforcement agents who have different statutory obligations. Excuse me, just hold on. EFCC has its statutory obligations, and it is with respect to financial crimes. Police has statutory obligations. It is established under the Police Act. Hold on, sir. Excuse me. DSS has statutory obligations established under the law establishing the DSS. So why would you carry a DSS to say go into the house of a judge because you are investigating, hold on, a financial crime? Ask me, excuse me, sir. Please hold on.
We are doing a kangaroo exercise.
Is what we are doing.
Agency or not?
The DSS is a security agency with the obligations.
Is the police a security agency or not?
Yes, it is.
So why can't they do the same thing?
The process is wrong. The process is wrong. You have not been able to tell me.
You have not been able to tell me any particular law that supports
on whose allegations, excuse me, sir. On whose allegations have that raid been conducted?
All right, guys.
Then carry DSS to bank officials. Carry them to their houses.
All right. Let's assume this happens. Eventually, it has happened. Where was it supposed to end?
The courts.
The courts?
The courts.
Okay.
The courts. And that is why I said the concepts of the rule of law has not been
breached. Okay, so it means that, it will mean to my mind, what I hear is that from you guys, is that eventually, no matter what avenues you use in getting to this destination, the ultimate destination is the courts.
The courts are justice.
So it means that everything that happens there will be based on prosecution and defense.
Very well.
And let me tell you the potholes. So DSS believes in the law.
No, hold on a minute. Let me tell you the potholes they are likely now to face, okay, from what they have done. We wanted, and I would have loved for you to try to educate Nigerians on the procedure. Okay, now, sir, you have investigated a judge. And so to speak, they've taken that the funds that they found in the house, the cash. It's not exhibit, right, sir? So where should that be kept, first of all? You can tell us that. Where should it be kept in the event we are going through prosecution? Now, sir, have you suspended them? Are you going to put a serving judge in the dock, sir? If you want to answer that question, which were the things that should have been done? Which was the process that should have thought about? Now, are you going to put a serving judge? Because as of today, they are still serving justices.
Okay, so these judges that have been arrested, I would deliberately ask that question to say, where is this going to end? So if it's going to end in the court, how will they be arraigned?
Okay.
Is the one supporting DSS?
I will tell you. It's easy. The law clearly lays down a procedure for investigation of crime and for prosecution. Now, we are on the same page
yes, sir.
That judges are under the law
yes, sir.
and no one is above the law.
Yes, sir.
The moment we have been able to preserve evidence, because as it is, the exhibits that were recovered,
yes, sir,
because you asked where are they being kept,
yes, sir,
of course they will be with the security agency that conducted the raid.
Okay.
And then they will be charged to court.
Okay. Who will charge them to
court? We have the office of the AGF.
Okay, so
we DSS, have the office of the AGF.
So DSS
we
reports,
have the office of,
no, hold on. So DSS reports back to the Attorney General.
The Attorney General is the custodian of the law.
Oh, fantastic. But so, this offense, and that's something you should have averted your mind to.
Okay, hold on, guys. Just let's take it like this. I'll just take two tweets, just two tweets, and you can just give me your closing statements on this. Just, you're going to wrap up how this process should start and end, or how it supposedly would start and end. And you're going to do that in 30 seconds. Let me just read two tweets. This is from Olaleko Adisa. Government definitely will struggle to convince rational minds that this approach is the best under the circumstance. Fola Oyinbo says, are we saying that judges are above the law? Keeping that in mind, let's look at this entire process, whether sting operation, whether bee operation, whether butterfly operation. How would it have started and ended to the point where, to the extent to which, to the fact that what we are thinking or what we have been made to understand in terms of corruption and finding people guilty, eventually somebody would have been put maybe behind bars or something. I mean, just quickly, in 30 seconds, who goes first?
No, let me just say this.
Quickly, yeah. Now, and that's your closing statement.
Okay, very well. Now, this government is fighting corruption,
yes, sir,
and not the judiciary.
Yes, sir.
The independence of the judiciary remains sacrosanct,
yes, sir,
and it remains highly respected.
Yes, sir.
When these judges that have been arrested, if they are, the moment we collate all, the moment the evidence is collated,
yes,
then they will be taken to court.
Yes,
they have an opportunity to state their own ends, their own side of the story, and an opportunity to prove their innocence.
Would they be docked?
Of course, yes.
Okay,
they are not above the law.
Thank you.
Well, I think that he has deliberately left out some sacrosanct parts of the process. Number one, you cannot arraign a serving judicial officer. It's not even commonsensical for you to say you want to put a serving judicial officer in the dock.
He has not been suspended.
He's not been suspended. That's number one. Number two, of all of these things, is it that the worry is because of the money is found in the house or because we are sure that they were bribed? If they were bribed, who did the bribery? Has that person been arrested?
Well, we'll get
we have already crossed the bridge.
Okay, so
we have already crossed the bridge.
Yes.
So I'm saying that the process is faulty. It's okay. Obvious. Prosecution cannot be rightly done. This is not to say that anybody found guilty of corruption should not be prosecuted and sentenced.
That's the point. We can call it a wrap. All guys out there, we thank you for joining us tonight again on Face Off. We looked at the DSS, or we'll be looking at the DSS raid on judges. And yes, I think this will continue to resonate in our political history for a very long time to come. Be that as it may, we want a country that is safe, sound, and where we want to be in terms of where we want to be as a nation is what we advocate, even here on this program. Join us again next week on Face Up. Bye for now.